So first off, we need to be aggressive. If you can move close to the service line, that will be easier for you to do in a much higher and more aggressive position. So really try to add some movement towards the net in order for you to do better shots, especially in this deception return. Have your racket in front of you. Want to show your opponent that I am attacking this. It's also easier for you to meet it early, because that is tip number two. When we move forward, we need to approach the shuttle very, very early up here. Show that we want to hit it in this position, but pull back and then hit it cross instead of that way. So in this position, you have to use your arm and your body to create the deception. So all of the things you're doing has to move this way. So your opponent is thinking, okay, he's hitting this way. But just in the end, you add the deception. It's very, very important to use your arm and your body at the same time, going like this. Both of the shots, you need to add finger power, and you need to have more or less the same grip. You need to have your thumb working a lot. You can start with the bevel grip, but you can change around when you hit it to the thumb grip, adding the power down here or up here. So a bevel grip in the start, move around, adding finger power using the thumb grip. At a more defensive position, you need to add a little bit more deception. You really need to fool the opponent in the back. Otherwise, it will be very, very dangerous to do a shot from this position going a little bit upwards to that corner. So you really need to be sharp now if you are reaching it at a lower position. It's still the same thing going on with the wrist. You still need to push with your thumb, but you also need to add a little bit more movement with your arm. So guys, that was it. Wasn't it a cool shot? I really hope that you can see what's going on with some of the small details of our different clips here and slow motion and stuff. Try it out yourself and see if it works, okay? Don't be afraid of trying to use this. Do it in your training before you do it in a match. And just watch it over and over again to learn the details. And remember to hit the subscribe button and the small bell so you will get our content in your feed here on YouTube. So have a great day, everybody. Stay safe. Maybe watch our videos, get out there, practice if you have the chance to do that today. Have a great day and see you next time in this another video tutorial. Bye.